Hey guys, it's Andy from Vanguard Trick, and today we are learning sideswipe. So prerequisites for this is going to be a tornado kick at level 5 and also a 540 at level 5. So if you don't know what I mean by a level 5 trick, check out the video up here where we talk about how to grade your tricks. Also, if you can raise, that'll give you a good insight into stepping, arching and lifting. But if you can't raise yet, don't worry, it's not mandatory. The most important prerequisite though is a rear leg round kick. That is the most important thing by far. There are two different types of sideswipe. There is one that's more of a body roll, that'd be easy if you've got a very good, strong 540. And then there is one where we come over and we twist and then we arch ourselves, that is much more like a raise. So if you've got a strong raise, that's the one for you. So before we get into the tutorial and telling you what a sideswipe is, I'm gonna tell you what a sideswipe isn't. It is not your regular 540 done upside down. Also, it's not a raise switch. It might feel like one, but don't think of it as a raise switch because it won't help you in the technique. So four things that are absolutely critical in a sideswipe. You've got to have good balance. The timing for this is all new, and so is the body position that we're going to get into to execute the technique. And finally, commitment. This is not a move you can do a baby version of. When you go for it, you've got to go 100%. So for this, our first two drills are going to be using a tornado kick and a 540. The difference we're going to be making here is we're going to change from using a crescent kick to a round kick. And I'm going to show you the key difference. Okay, so crescent kick in a tornado or a 540 comes around like so. And my hips stay facing the front. Kick starts from the bottom and works all the way through. Round kick is different. We're here, come up, and we come through. And I've got a turn, a lift, and then a kick. And then we're done. So the drills we're going to be looking at first is our tornado kick and our 540. And we're going to be getting different things from the different drills. That means we're going to be using a crescent kick on our tornadoes and a round kick on our 540s. On a sideswipe, we're definitely going to be using a round kick. There is a very good reason why we are not going to be using a crescent kick in this sideswipe, and I'll show you. So we're over doing our sideswipe here. Our kicking leg is up in the air. We're either giving ourselves a nice boat foot or we're pointing our toes. And the crescent kick, we come round and we under rotate, snap. That is how you do your knee in, AKA Chris de Vera style. If we're doing a round kick instead, as we come around, you can actually land on the ball of the foot, and then worst case scenario is that you bend the knee and you can put the hands down. Drill number one, tweaking your tornado kick. For this, we're gonna be changing the way we use our arms, changing where we spot, and changing how we step into the technique. So for this one, we're gonna be referring to a clock face. This clock face is always vertical, no matter where your body is. On a regular tornado, we'll probably swing our arms from 3 to 12, and then pull them in, because all we wanna do is get a bit of momentum and a little bit of lift. For this drill for sideswipe, we're gonna come bring the arms all the way around from 3 to 10. We're gonna bring them all the way past 12 and over here. So we've got more of an arm motion going on. This doesn't mean you can start it later and go to here, from here all the way over. Next part on this is gonna be changing where we spot. Normally the tornado, we spot forward, round, and then spot again. For this drill, we're gonna be looking to the side. So also, on a tornado kick, where we step over doesn't really matter. When it comes to sideswipe, it makes a huge difference. If I step to here, I'm gonna have to lift, arch, and twist more like I would in a raise. If I do my sideswipe like this, and I step all the way over, I'm gonna do more of a body roll where I'm gonna come over my shoulder here. We're gonna cover these in a lot more detail in the next section. Okay, before we apply this to a 540, the thing we have to remember is the importance of the non-kicking leg. That non-kicking leg will give us the lift, and the lift will determine the inversion. The second is about body positioning. We have to give our body a little bit of space to be able to turn over or to be able to arch and twist into the side swipe. A 540 you can do on the spot and stay pretty much here, but you can't do a side swipe by just going to a 540 setup and just doing that. But you can do it, but only the once. Drill two, tweaking your 540. In this one, we are going to be changing our 540 from being front facing to being side facing, just like we did on the tornado. For this one, we want to have a level 5 540 kick. That's because we've got to be able to throw his full power while still able to make some subtle changes. So we're going to be changing our takeoff, our hip position, and our spotting, as well as changing the kick from just a jabbing kick where we kick all the way through to a smarter kick. On a normal 540, we can kick from 3 all the way through to 9 if we wanted to. On a side swipe, doing 3 to 9 won't work. For this one, we're gonna drill our 540, starting the kick at 1 or even 12. But to do this, we have to lift, chamber, kick, and then bring that leg through. So normally on a 540, my target is in front of me, and that's where I'm spotting. I'm here, I step across, I lift my arms up, back towards my target, and I kick, and then I come through here. On this drill for the side swipe though, I'm gonna change everything from here to over here. So, I still start off in this position. I bring the arms around and I spot here. My leg is facing towards the back. I bring the arms all the way around from 3 to 10 and I spot over here. I kick with a round kick and I come back through again. So let's have a look at these setups. First of all, we're looking at the body roll. This is where we will step in. So our foot faces towards the back. And typically when we lift a non-kicking leg, it's gonna be bent. That means our hips stay closed, which means we can turn ourselves over, that rolling over, to get into the kicking position. The downside of this is that it's probably gonna be a little bit lower because when we're here, our height is set to there. And also it's harder to spot the floor because once I've come to here and I've spotted once, I've gotta go all the way around before I've spotted it again. So there are some good things about using this body roll takeoff. If you are just turning over, it will feel a lot more like your 540. So doing the move like this will feel a bit safer. It will also mean you can do the move on the spot. So let's have a look at the second takeoff, the twist and the arch. So on the setup before, we step and the foot faces the back. Now we're gonna take a smaller setup here, just like we do on a regular raise. Same as on the raise, we come down, we're spotting, and then we're gonna carry on spotting the whole way as we come through. So from here, round as we open up our hips by lifting that non-kicking leg up. The benefit to this is that if you're familiar with raise, you can get a good lift and you'll be familiar with the timing. If raise isn't your strong point, then it's gonna feel like you've gotta wait a really long time to get all the way around into position before you can kick. So when it comes to learning side swipe, you might think, okay, well, which setup should I be using? The truth is you should stick to your strengths. If you've got a strong 540, we'll use the body roll. If you've got a strong raise, you can use that twist and the arch. And there are benefits to doing both. We have to remember though that we must change them from either just being a regular 540 or just being a regular raise. So for that 540 body roll style takeoff, we have to remember that we are using the arms to get ourselves all the way over, and we have to lift our non-kicking leg up hard to turn our hips over the whole way. Final thing we have to remember is that we're not using that crescent kick anymore, we must use a round kick to get the side swipe right. So for that raise style takeoff, the thing we have to remember is that normally on a raise, that non-kicking leg comes all the way over. On this one, we're gonna lift it to where it's gonna be finished being useful, and then we're gonna get rid of it, its job is done. And we have to use the arms not only just to get us up, but to get us round a little bit further to get our hips into position to throw that kick. So once you've got this move to a level 2 or level 3 where you're starting to land it, you can start to blend these two together to get the best side swipe for you. Me personally, I do more of a body roll, but I still use an arch in there as well, because that will give you the best overall side swipe. Before we move on to the next drill, there's one piece of advice that loads of people give on kicking tricks that sounds good, but isn't actually that helpful. They say, you've got to kick all the way through. Yeah, when you start off side swipe, you can't just stop kicking, so you are kicking all the way through. But that kind of implies that our power and our tension for the kick is going to get higher and higher and higher as we kick through the side swipe. That's not the case. What we want to do is have more of a bell curve of our power. So in the setup, we're not going to be putting any power into the kick. As we lift the leg ready for the kick, we're putting a little bit of power in. At the peak of the kick, we're going to be smashing the power as hard as we can. And then afterwards, we're going to keep core tension, but we're not going to be folding ourselves around the leg. Otherwise, we're going to end up landing really low. All right, so drill number three, we're going to be digging out the secret sauce for this one. This drill will help you with the timing, the lift, and the power in the kick all in one. Okay, so for this drill, we're gonna start sat down. We're gonna have our non-kicking leg is gonna be out straight and our kicking leg is gonna be bent like this. So we're gonna imagine that our target is gonna be about here in the middle and we're gonna be traveling in this direction over here. So I'm gonna start with my left foot on the floor and my right hand up in the air. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring my hand over to this position. Then I'm gonna push off this just like I would in a 540 or a side swipe. I'm gonna lift myself up, drive this leg up as high as I can, spot the floor, and then when I'm inverted, then I'm gonna kick and land on the kicking leg. Whole thing together should be like this. This drill is so useful. You can do this a million times and you're not gonna hurt yourself. What you want to try and do is play around with how high you lift that leg, how early you kick, and what position you're in when you actually execute the kick. So you can play around with doing it where you kick really early, lift the leg up low, snap that kick over, see what happens. You can experiment with bringing the leg almost all the way over and then doing like a raised switch. Or you can do it where you lift up and do a very shallow kick and you'll see that you end up doing a crescent. The good thing with this drill is that it teaches you what to expect when you're coming in to land, and not that many kick drills do that. So if you do this one right, it should teach you exactly what a good side swipe is going to feel like. So before we move on to doing the whole side swipe, you have to have that hand plant drill absolutely down. You've got to be super comfortable with lifting up, kicking at the peak, and coming out in a controlled manner. If you haven't got that, don't try and do the full side swipe just yet. All right, drill four is the full side swipe. Now warning, before we do this, you must commit to the move entirely. 90% commitment means 100% failure. Okay, let's run through the side swipe in four stages. The first one is gonna be the setup. So we're gonna step from here, our arm's gonna go from 3 all the way through until 10. Remember that clock face is vertical, so even when I'm down, that doesn't mean that I'm gonna be lifting over here. It means up nice and high. Also spotting, not spotting in front anymore, I'm spotting over to the side. So from here, I come around and I spot. Where the head goes will be dependent on whether I'm doing the body roll or whether I'm doing the raised style takeoff. That takes us to stage two, the lift. So from here, wherever I've stepped to, I've got to lift that non-kicking leg up as hard as I can. Now, if I'm doing the raised style setup, I'm going to set myself here, and then I'm going to keep looking at the same spot, lift and twist over, keep my arm in the same position. If I'm doing the body roll style takeoff, as I step, I've got my spot. Now I'm going to come back around again, looking over my shoulder over here to get that spot again. Stage three is going to be the kick. So we've come around, we've spotted, we've decided whether we're going to do the twist or we're going to do the body roll, and we've lifted that non-kicking leg up nice and high. Now we must lift the leg up here, perform the kick, and then follow it over. So we lift, we kick, and then we keep our core tension as we come over. So that brings on to stage four, the landing. We've come around, we've spotted, we've lifted, thrown the kick. Now we're going to not crunch around the leg here. We're going to kick, keep core tension, and then try and land 90 degrees or higher. So let's see what the whole thing looks like in one go. So the focus point for the side swipe, it's going to look like an inverted 540, but we know there's a lot more to it than that. For me, the biggest thing to think about is the arms. It's 150% of a normal 540 motion, because not just coming to here, we're coming all the way over. And it's gonna feel like a really fast, whippy 540 with a jabby kick. Your arms are your anchors. If you throw those anchors down, you're going down. If you pull them in, you will stay up high. When we're setting ourselves for the side swipe, let's say I've come over and I'm here. If I pull that arm down, then you can see how it's gonna drag me down towards the floor. If I bring them over and then pull it in on this axis, it means I'm gonna be able to rotate over much more easily and maintain my height. So now we've got our side swipe, it's either a level 2 or a level 3. I'm gonna give you one tip that's gonna reset almost everything. You don't actually have to dip on a side swipe. The reason why we dip is because we're doing a side-to-side takeoff and we haven't got a lot of momentum moving into it. So when we don't have a lot of momentum, we have to dip the head down to get the hips up in that seesaw motion. If we've got a ton of momentum, we can keep the head here and use the momentum just to pitch our hips up higher. So once you've got the side swipe down, you can do it every single time, play around with doing a hook kick into it or doing a really big side step into it to see if you can reduce the amount of dip and trying to get your hips up even higher. This will give you the highest side swipes possible. Okay, so you've got your side swipe. Let's make it better, let's troubleshoot. Okay, problem number one, not getting inverted. This is probably because we're doing a body roll and just turning over and more falling than turning into it. Easy fix for this, go back to drill number 3, that hand plant, and focus on aggressively lifting that non-kicking leg and spotting the floor and then waiting longer and longer before you kick. Get that drill down, then go back to the full side swipe, should fix it. Okay, problem number 2, landing low. This is probably because we're not putting 100% power into it. Your arms must be fast, your non-kicking leg lifting up must be fast, the kick must be hard. Most likely you're not doing all these as hard as you possibly can. But you also might have some problems as well where your arms, when they come over, you're using them as anchors again to pull you down. Also, you might be doing a crescent kick and then not being able to get the rotation and you're just falling. Turn it over, get that round kick. Easy fix for this one. Put in full power every single time and use that hand plant drill to make sure you know what it feels like when you do put 100% in. Problem number 3, no real kick. Simple fix for this one, go back, drill your rear leg round kick. Lift, snap that kick, and then through. Then once you've done that a bunch of times, go back to the hand plant drill and get the kick snapping super hard on those. If you're doing this in more of the raised style, this is a fairly common problem to have. Okay, problem number 4, landing heavy. It's most likely because we're not turning ourselves all the way over. You must use those arms to get you up, around. Use the arms to get you over, spot over, turn the hips over. If you get everything over, you've got a clear path to doing a fast kick and land upright. Problem number 5, not being able to combo it. Comboing into this move means you have to reset to get a proper step into it. You can't rush it. You must fulfill every part of this technique to do it properly. And comboing out of it, most commonly people will crunch around that leg, trying to keep in too much power, and they won't be able to come out of it upright. Kick, keep core tension, and then land at that 90 degrees or higher, and you'll find comboing out of this move a lot easier. So guys, that brings us to the end of the side swipe tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to click the like and subscribe button, ring that sub notification bell. And I want you to film your side swipes and upload them to Instagram and tag us at Vanguard Tricking, because we want to see your progress each and every day. Until next time guys, see you later.